Do you hear him calling for more? Calling for more and more and more and more of you. Oh, he's calling for more and more and more and more and more of you. Oh, we know your answer. We know your answer.
We know your answer.
Oh, we know your answer.
We know your answer.
Every single time.
Every time.
Oh,
we know your answer.
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 Somebody. He said, I'm calling you hero. Then on top of that, not only that, perfected praise came down and they did something that surprised people up. Well, God is moving. He got everything just set up just right. So can the house just begin to give God some praise? Come on, can we really give God some praise? God is worthy of our praise. Come on, I know you done had a little bit to eat, but you know what? God is worthy of our praise. I'm calling you. And that's the lovely thing about God, because God knows each and every one of our names. You know how you run into somebody that you ain't seen in a while, but and you can't quite think of their name. But let me tell you something, every time you get into the presence of God, God knows your name. And before he comes, right now his name is Bishop Charles Franklin. But when I pass the mic to him and he stands behind the pulpit, he's no longer Charles Franklin. He's a son of God. And I believe God is getting ready to speak a mighty word through this man of God, because the atmosphere is conducive for you to be able to break yokes and destroy bonds. So I just want you one more time to give God praise for the man of God. I present to you, formerly known as Bishop Charles Franklin, now going by the Son of God. Let's receive him.
Please be seated. Hallelujah. I am just as full as you are, because he, in the last 2 weeks, have been calling me deeper and deeper. Come on, vessel. We're not going to interrupt the Spirit. Glory be to God.
Yes.
It's so ironic, Brother Majors, because I was playing your CD on the way down, and that has become my favorite. Hallelujah. Come on.
I need all the temple members to stand. This song is for you guys, so it's going to take some participation. So, y'all ready?
You are born, you are born, champion, champion, 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 you are born, you are born, champion, champion,
about the temple today that I've not seen before. I felt it when I came in. Sister Christy, where are you? She's gone. Well, when y'all see her, tell her she missed her blessing. Because God told me to lay hands upon her and to pray for her, because the anointing that was on her as your worship leader today is not going to be.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Somebody's going to catch that. It always takes a worship leader to lead you into praise.
The children of Israel did not really appreciate the victory when they came across the Red Sea, but Miriam. Hallelujah.
Come on.
Miriam reminded them that God was with us all the time.
Hallelujah.
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 Sister Christy reminded us that this might be a church anniversary, but for the 17 years that we've been here, God has always been with us. Hallelujah. In the word today, the word victory, God told me victory does not necessarily mean what we think it means in our finite mind. So he sent me to my concordance and he said, go to the Greek. And when you pick out victorious and you find it in the Greek, it means that you turned around.
Come on, minister.
Victory doesn't come until we turn around. Victory does not come until we understand that the direction we're going in is not the right direction. I've got to turn around.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You don't believe me? Go check it out.
Hallelujah.
Turn around. Turn about.
Woo!
That's victory. Hallelujah. Oh, there she is. There she is. Somebody get the oil. Come forward. Spirit of the living God said for me to pray for you.
Amen.
And I'm not praying for you because you need prayer. I'm praying for you because the anointing that was on you has been on you today as the worship leader. It was genuine. It was the power of God.
Amen.
And you did not let the people that did not praise God bother you. You kept on pushing. Hallelujah. So you took us deeper and deeper into worship.
Amen.
And then the praise just began to flow.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus' name.
Yes. Yes, Lord.
The power of the Holy Spirit shall remain, shall abide in this vessel. This day, in the name of Jesus the Christ.
My God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on, come on.
Somebody praise God with us. Somebody praise God with us. Somebody praise God with us. Somebody praise God with her. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Have your way, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Fresh. Fresh oil. Fresh oil. Some of you need fresh oil. You're running on old, dirty oil. Hallelujah. Fill me up, Lord. Hallelujah. Fill me up, Lord. Hallelujah. Hey, glory. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. The fellowship for the next 2 years will go no further than the three of us and the senior bishop. And God said that in these days, it's hard to find that have the true love of God. They are not afraid to preach an uncompromising gospel. He said the field is too full of compromising pastors. It's not about apostles. It's not about bishops. It's not about bishops. It's not about bishops. It's about the kingdom. And the nomenclature of this fellowship is kingdom builders. And God said that he's going to build the kingdom with what he has. He said too many would tear it up. So I'm going to use what I have because we are planted. Eternity. The temple, perfected praise, are becoming like trees that are planted by the rivers of water. And our roots are going deeper and deeper. I don't know why he picked the number 2. But he said for the next 2 years, he said, don't get in a hurry. He said, invite and let them come and see. Hallelujah. But in John 4, it said, try the Spirit. By the Spirit of the living God. There's no mistake that no one's here but the fellowship.
Come on.
Divinely orchestrated by God. Man. I'm in a different place. I'm in a new place. You're getting ready to get your money. Get ready. If you haven't already got it, your building's growing up.
Yeah.
He said you won't have to do it by yourself. He said you're going to have some shoulders to lean on. Some bacon. Ah! It's some things that are not well done yet. Ah! Somebody shout victory. Shout it again.
Victory!
Now somebody stand up and turn around, because the victory belongs to the devil. The victory belongs to eternity. The victory belongs to perfected praise. Hallelujah. And if there's going to be a few more obstacles, but you will overcome, the victory will be ours. Hallelujah. People. We're going to see more souls get saved in the closing of this year and the beginning of next year than we've never seen before. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! He said, get ready. He said, be prepared. He said, I've come and I've told you how I'm getting ready to move. I'm already moving. Now you catch up and you keep up, because I'm God. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah. 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 This house is full of love. He said that we in these past years have learned how to really love one another. There's no jealousy, no envy. Hallelujah. When one gains success, he said we all gain success, because we're many members, but we're one body, and he's going to use this fellowship as an example for other apostles, for other bishops, for other laypeople, letting them know that this is real. This is what I'm calling for in these last and evil days. I need an eternity. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Is not standing behind this pulpit, but the Son of God. And when I was standing there, and he said that something touched my body. When it touched my body, it came and my lips began to burn. And God said, not only are you the Son of God, but I call you friend. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I thank God that I'm his friend. I thank God that I feel loved enough for him to say, I call you friend as the Son of God. Sometimes we got to stop seeing ourselves as we are and see that we're sons and daughters of the Most High God. Somebody shout, yeah! All we got to do is be obedient. Just be obedient. Just be obedient. There's a lot of obedience in this house. Glory. Hallelujah, God. Jehovah. God, the God of our very souls. We thank you that you sit high, but you look low. We thank you for looking and smiling down on the temple today. Your glory is in this place. We will leave different, God, than when we came in. We'll leave giving you the praise. We'll leave saying thank you, Lord, for another day's journey. And thank you that in this worship service, you've taken us deeper. Ooh. You've taken us deeper into the depths of your love. So thank you. And I pray that the words of these lips of clay and the meditations that are in my heart will be acceptable to you, Lord, as you use me as your instrument to speak to these, your people. But Lord, we claim nothing but victory, because today there is a turnabout of our praise. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. 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 To God be the glory. Wow. I only have one regret, that my wife is not here.
Well.
But sometimes you need to stand
alone
to understand that you're not alone.
Well,
that the Lord is with you. If you open your Bibles quickly to 1 John chapter 5, and we're going to look at verse number 4. How can I say thanks for all those things that he's done for me? Things so undeserved.
My God.
Yet, he gave his life. For me. Hallelujah. 1 John chapter 5, verse number 4, says from the King James,
all right,
for whatsoever is born of God, overcome the world.
Yes, sir.
And this is the
victory
that overcome the world, even our faith.
Yes.
You may be seated in the presence
of
the living God.
All right, preach that. Good.
Bless the Lord.
I want you to have a pencil and a piece of paper, because I'm going to give you some definitions that as you continue your Christian walk to remember. And then I'm going to give you an acronym of faith, and I'm going to sit down. Hallelujah. Y'all don't believe me. But it's going to happen. Listen,
I want to read something to you. I want to read 1 John chapter 5, and I want to read down through verse number 5. And I want to read it from the Message Bible.
Yeah, yeah.
Listen closely. Every person who believes that Jesus is in fact the Messiah is God begotten. If we love the one who conceives the child, we'll surely love the child who was conceived. The reality test on whether or not we love God's children is this: do we love God?
Yes, sir.
Do we keep his commands? The proof that we love God comes when we keep his commandments and they are not at all troubles.
All right.
My. The test of whether we love God or not.
All right.
Is do we love each other? You can't love me and not love God. Because God is love. Oh yes, somebody don't believe that. But it's in the fourth chapter. It's one chapter back before the chapter that we're in. Amen. And it says that God is love. Now, I want to talk to you about the proof is in the pudding. The proof is in the pudding, and you've already decided on which way I'm going, but be careful, because you could be wrong. In order for there to be a church of victorious overcomers, they must first be born again. Listen now. You have to be born again. One of the things that I discern about the temple and eternity and perfected praise is that, yes, we do have members that have been born again. Because the proof is in the pudding. In chapter 5, it actually gives us threefold proof of being born again. The first proof is that you have to believe that Jesus is the Christ and he's born of God.
Yes, sir.
The tears that you were just shedding.
Believe. All right.
Come on.
That in you that somebody wants to call emotion, but it's not. It's the anointing. Because when you're born again, you're already anointed. See, too many of us are waiting on the anointing. But you're already anointed. When you're born again, you are already anointed. So you're walking around as an anointed man or woman of God, son or daughter of God, and don't even realize. And because we are anointed, when we're... Listen, if you don't believe me, just keep reading your Bible.
Keep reading.
When we're born again, the Spirit of the living God abides in us.
That's right.
Yes, he does.
That's right.
God is anointed.
Somebody
don't believe me.
All right.
Listen. Because we believe, allow God to come in, because our belief is nothing but an act of faith.
All right.
So when we believe, that is the inward proof that we've been born again. The second proof that's in the pudding is everyone that loves is born of God. Hello? Amen. Now that is the outgoing proof. The outgoing. See, because you can't keep love in. You got to let love out. Amen? Amen? You shouldn't have sit on the front, but I got you now. Amen. Every time I come to the temple,
This brother shows outgoing proof that he's born again, because he never fails to speak to me. He never fails to hug me. He never fails to say, "Hey, preacher, you are right in my book." Amen. Amen. And every time I see this man, see, now that's the temple, and this is eternity. And Deacon never fails.
"Hey, preacher,
how you doing?" And you can just feel the love. Hallelujah. And then when this man played the guitar, you feel the love from the guitar as he sits there and he says, "I'm not playing for me. I'm not playing for Bishop. I'm playing for the kingdom." And the guitar has a way of making you look over there to see who's playing. Go ahead, hallelujah. The majors cannot lead and sing the way that they do without the love of God being in them and them not believing that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. You can't sing about the Son of God and don't believe he's a...
Come on, man.
Watch who touches me. I watch who shakes my hand. And watch this. I don't have to be at the church. I can be at the mall. Hallelujah. And when you run into children that believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, children of God that love him, you can hold conversations without ever talking about bad stuff. Hallelujah. That lets me know that they love the Lord.
Right.
Amen. Old folk, where Christy went, "I understood what you were saying, just don't call us old." The season, Christians used to sing a song, "I love the Lord, he heard my cry, and hid it every wrong. Long as trouble rise, I'll hasten to his throne." Now there's a lot to be said in that. You have to be born again. Hallelujah. You can't love God if you don't know that he has helped you through your trials and tribulations. Hallelujah. You know what you're talking about. And then the third proof is righteousness. Everyone that does righteousness is born of him. You are born of God, and you will make a practice of doing right at all times and at all costs. Hello. Hello, I was looking for my little sister that goes to eternity. She's just full of fire, huh? She was sitting right over here. Yeah. She just stepped out. Okay. Now, I wanted to use her because she's been through more out of all of the members that I know at eternity than a lot of us. But no matter what, she remains in right standing with God. I know this is the 17th anniversary of the temple, but God told me to come here and speak to the fellowship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We got, at Perfected Prayer, we got a long way to get to 17. Amen. But we'll get there. God being our helper. Amen. So, if you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, if you love God and your fellow man, and you are in right standing with God, the proof is in the pudding that you have been born again. Now that we set the foundation, because anything without a foundation is rocky. And it won't stand. So we have set the foundation for the word, because the theme is a church of victorious overcomers. Now, the church, touch your neighbor and say, "The church is you." Hallelujah. The church is me. Amen. Say, "I'm just in the confound of four walls."
Yeah.
Come on, say, I'm just in the confound of four walls.
Yeah.
But I've come to assemble with many other churches.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So now that we have 75 to 100 churches in here, and each church has their own name, there's some daughters and there's some sons. There's only two names. Some of us are daughters and some of us are sons. He don't know me by Charles. Because the scripture says that he doesn't look at the outward appearance of me, but he looks at my heart. Hallelujah. So my heart tells him how much I love him. Hallelujah. Charles doesn't tell him how much I love him. Bishop don't tell him how much I love him. My children call me daddy. My wife calls me Charles. On the job, they call me Charles, but God says son. Now listen, these are the words I want you to write down. A church of victorious overcomers. Now, we're going to put overcomer because you have to be an overcomer when we really get the Greek definition of overcome, and then we can be victorious because we've kept the commands of God. Amen? So, overcome in the Greek means subdue.
All right.
Subdue.
All right.
Now, I'm going to help you before you think about subduing, putting something down. Subdue in the Greek, when we use overcome, means submit self unto. Now, the reason that it didn't go any further than that, because you might have to submit yourself unto God. You might have to submit yourself unto apostles.
Yeah.
You might have to submit yourself unto your husband.
Yeah.
You might have to submit yourself unto your wife.
Yeah.
Hello, man, I know you think that's strange.
No.
The children have to submit themselves unto their parents. Amen? So when we look at the word overcome, meaning to subdue, subdue means submit yourself unto. So if we are really going to be overcomers, it means that we have submitted ourselves unto God. And I told you that victory was to turn about. And because I submitted myself unto God, hallelujah, hello, overcomer. See, when I was in sin, I was thinking deeply. And I was in darkness. Amen? But when I got saved, I became an overcomer. Hello. Because I submitted self unto God. So my victory was my turnaround. Amen? Now, in that fourth verse that we use in your scripture, 2 through 4, it used the word commandments. In the Greek, commandment means an authoritative prescription.
Right.
How many of you go to the pharmacy to get prescriptions?
Oh, yeah.
Okay? When you get the prescription,
whatever the pill is for, or whatever the medicine is for, is to make you well.
Right.
So the prescription that he gave us hung on the cross. That was the prescription. Now, remember, before that I said authoritative prescription.
Yes, sir.
So what God said is because that is, I give you the prescription, understand that him hanging on the cross was only a recommendation. See, you call in the prescription, but if you don't go get it, you can't use it. So a lot of us will run up here on a Sunday morning and give our life to God, but we don't go fill the prescription. So we wonder why we're not able to submit unto the Lord. Am I going somewhere? So because they didn't go get the prescription, they were not able to turn around. They were not able to turn to. Amen? So the reason it says authority, he wants you to know that I'm the one that has authority because I'm the creator and you are the creation. So since I made you in my image and my likeness, I have the authority over you, but I won't be Lord. I give you choice. Hallelujah. So now that we got that out of the way, the foundation has been set, we got that out of the way, it all had to be done by faith. Here we go. Get ready for the acronym. Faith. Faith is freedom in Christ. The F in faith is freedom in Christ. If therefore the Son shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Then the A is assurance from Christ. But Jesus said, do not be afraid any longer, only believe. See, when I look at the fellowship, I see saints of God that can get behind the vision of the pastors and help him push it because they know that they are free and they have the assurance that God hears their prayers. Why? Because they are free. Because he said those that he made free, they are free. Indeed, I'm free to walk amongst sinners and remain saved. I'm free to go to my job and talk about Jesus Christ and never lose it. I'm free to go to my home and have prayer openly and with my children without worrying about the government coming in. Ah, because I'm free. Hallelujah. And I have the assurance. Hallelujah. That if I just hold on to God's unchanging hand and remember that now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen, when I step out on my assurance, I'm going to see some results. Yeah. Hallelujah. Oh, the I in faith means I got to be involved for Christ, not with Christ. All right. All right. Well, since he made me free and he's given me the assurance, Matthew 9 and 37 said that the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. What's happening is churches are no longer sending the members out. We're keeping them inside the confines of these walls so that we can preach a compromising gospel. I didn't say uncompromising. A compromising gospel that we can receive filthy lucre, that I can keep getting paid, that I can keep driving my cattle. Oh, y'all know that. Oh, but the I says you got to get involved for Christ. I stands for involvement. It is the center of the word faith. Failure at this point means losing the victory of freedom and assurance and the blessings to come. Hallelujah. You got to tell the story. You can't keep it a secret. How did you get saved? Hallelujah. Tell somebody the story. Tell them that come down to the temple. Ah, we got it going on down there. I need you to just drive a little ways north to Sherman, Texas. I know that if it's, y'all not hearing me. If it's alive, it's worth the drive. And we want you to know that we are alive. Hallelujah. You got to get out. You got to rub shoulders with the sinner and the saint. You got to let them know I go to church every Sunday. You're not going to make me work. Just as God gave me this job, he'll give me another one. I'm going to stand on the assurance of God because he made me free. And he said, those I make free, they are free indeed. So I'm getting involved for Christ, not with Christ. Jesus, I'm going to tell them how you hung, bled, and died, that they don't have to lie no more. Hung, bled, and died, that they don't have to be jealous anymore. Hung, bled, and died, that they don't have to run away from their problems anymore. Hallelujah. The proof is in the pudding. I'm almost finished. I'm almost finished. Listen. The victory of faith includes working for Christ. For faith without works is dead. I got the faith to believe that I'm going to get a raise because that's coming to me. No, wait a minute. Wait a minute. That ain't work. Hallelujah. That's not work. You just can't come up in here
and hear Malachi 3 verse that I'll open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that there will not be room enough for you to receive. Luke 6 and 33, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over from the bosom of men. No. You got that twisted, baby. You got to get out there in the mark in the mirror where you come out of and let them know that for Christ I live and for Christ I die. You can come out of what you're in. You don't have to hold on to that drama. I can introduce you to a man by the name of Jesus that will make you free and give you the assurance as long as you get involved with him. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. I feel all right. The T means triumph through Christ. But in all these things, we overwhelmingly conquer through him who loved us. That's why when I say I am more than a conqueror, I'm not saying that I'm Superman. I'm not saying I'm Batman. I'm not saying I'm Iron Man. I'm saying that I work for a man by the name of Jesus. And Jesus, because I'm already anointed, allows me to feel his power to raise the dead, make the blind see, the dumb talk. You don't hear me because I'm free, because I got that assurance, because I get involved for Christ, because I am triumphant. I'm triumphant through Christ. He makes me more than a conqueror. I don't have to worry about rubbing shoulders with sinners. When I get a little contaminated, I just step and stand still. And I say, Lord, decontaminate me. He said, well, give me some praise. As I begin to praise him, the filth falls away from me. My feet get to dancing, my hands get to waving. I throw my head back and I can say, glory. Hallelujah. 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 Then the H. I love the H because as long as I've worked here, oh glory, Philippians 1 and 21 is my favorite scripture. For me to live is Christ, but to die is gain. What Paul was saying, as long as I'm on this side and I got freedom in Christ, I have his assurance. I have worked for him and being involved. I'm triumphant through Christ. But now he told me with an assurance that in my Father's house are many a mansion. If it were not so, I would have told you. This is my favorite part. He said, I go. I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, you may be also. Come on up a little higher, son. I didn't hear him call Charles. I heard him say, son. It didn't help me or mix me up. I knew he wasn't talking about you. I knew he wasn't talking about you. I knew he wasn't talking about you. Because my record speaks for itself. Your record is like a mama calling their child. It's good to live by. Somebody say it brings freedom. It brings assurance. It brings triumph. It brings involvement. And it'll surely bring you heaven. Hallelujah.
Yeah, yeah.
Listen, if I go to my seat, I just want to let you know that just a few days ago, as I was preparing this, because I thought I had the sermon already ready. And when my friend sent it to me. She said, whatever God gave you, it's got to be right. But God said when I read it, he said, I want you to change your word. So as I was sitting there contemplating and reading the scriptures, oh, and I just have to go here because it's just a part of me. And every time I go there, it takes me deeper. Deacon, my Bible fell open to Psalm 23. And if you don't mind, as I begin to read, it was my father talking to his son. And he said, son, I am your shepherd. I know you quit your job. You become a house mom. And I fix your wife to bring home the bacon. But you'll still fry it in the pan and never let her forget that you're still the man. I am your shepherd. I shall not want. I'll lay you down in green pastures. I'll lay you beside the still waters. Son, when you get down and out, I'm gonna restore your soul for my name's sake. And when you're walking through the valley of the shadow of death, I don't want you to fear no evil. Why is that, Lord? Because I'll be with you. My rod and my staff, they shall comfort you. Oh, Lord. As I sit there, he didn't stop there. He said, Charles, I know you've been through a lot. I know you've had some ups, but you've had more downs. But now, I got you. I'm on your side. I am preparing a table before you in the presence of your enemy. Your cup, oh glory, is gonna begin to run over. And when it runs over, understand that not only will your cup run over, but listen to me when I say surely. He didn't say it one time. Surely. He didn't say it two times. He said surely. My goodness and my mercy is going to follow you all the rest of your life. I said, well, Lord, I think I'm ready. I'm going to get up from here, and I'm going to tell them how they got to love you. And after they love you, because if they don't love you, they can't love Samaya. When they don't love you, they can't love Deacon. When they don't love you, they can't love Apostle. I'm going to tell them that if they love you, then they can love everybody. Because your love is like a blanket. It'll cover everybody. High five your neighbor and say, I'm everybody. The Holy Ghost being upon you. I see some of you standing. It's signs of the Holy Ghost covering you. I see some of you waving your hand. It's a sign of the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost! Ah, Holy Ghost! Have your way. Come on down in here. He's able. He's my bridge over troubled waters. He is my company keeper. He's a door that man has closed. He's my everything. He's a friend when I'm friendless. He, in the midnight hour, he's my guiding light. He sits high, but yet he looks low. He keeps me informed. He's a jealous God. He's a king of kings. He's the Lord of lords. He provides all I need. He's not looking for quality. He's looking for quality. Glory. Or when I'm in a weary land, he'll give me rest. Yes. Somebody say yes. He's my savior. He makes me triumphant. He'll understand and say, well done. Oh, glory. Well, come on up in there. He's victory. When I'm all alone, oh, glory. W, come on, Ezekiel. He's my wheel in the middle of the wheel. Oh, it. You don't think I can find anything for extra? Well, let me put my hand on my hip. He's an X-ray technician. Of my life, God is.
Everybody's dying. There's some people, your clock didn't wake you up. You just heard your clock after you woke up. Because there's some dead people whose clock's still running. And it's still people.